I am Grandmaster Saptarshi Roy. Today I want to show you some very important games. Again, R.R. Laxman with me, and this is very complicated game. So just put more focus for this game today. And well, this game we played in the ONGC Cup Hyderabad on 2006, and we both was 3 out of 3. I beat Laxman and I became 4. Anyway, Laxman is my very good friend, Grandmaster, but okay, in the game, you know, you have to put your more effort and whatever the result will come, you have to accept. So anyway, Laxman is a very good Catalan player and he is very positionally very solid. So he played knight f3 and I played c5. So why I played c5? I didn't expect before the game because Laxman will play e4. Because Laxman is basically d4 player, and I was expecting he will play c4 or maybe d4 in this position. I was quite prepared for that, but he played e4. I played d6. I was expecting, okay, if he'll move d4, I'll capture cd in d4, nf6 and c3, I'll play g6. And I'll play Sicilian Dragon against him because with positional player, it's very easy to continue. Well, Bishop b5, he played knight c6, short castle, bd7, rook e1, a6. I can remember a few months ago, I prepared this line before this tournament, and my preparation was if opponent react bishop f1, I can play bishop g4, and then h3, bishop h5, and c3. I can go with e6. My idea was to play knight f6, bishop e7, and short castle. And maybe later I can go with b5, queen b6, and rook e8, of course. So black can get very solid and good position in this line. So here opponent played bishop into c6. I capture bishop into c6. He played d4, c into d4, and knight into d4. So here I can show you if he moves queen into d4, immediately I can react with e5, queen d3, h6, c4, knight f6, knight c3, bishop e7, a4, and short castle. Okay, in this position, black is having double bishop advantage, only problem is d6 pawn, so here black plan should be on knight d7, knight c5, and knight e6. If he will get opportunity, he should go with a5. And one more plan is there, but sometimes it works, sometimes not. That is knight h5, king moves, and maybe later on f5 if possible. So, okay, knight into d4, he captured instead of queen into d4, and I played g6. Here I thought opponent will play knight c3, I can play bishop g7, knight f6 and short castle. But he react with knight into c6, b into c6 and e5. This move make me very surprised because I didn't expect my opponent to play this kind of move, because initially when I saw knight d into e5, queen f3, queen d5, and if white capture queen into d5, black can capture e into d5. C into d5, rook into e5 and e6. After this move, I believe black structure is more stronger, and black can move later bishop g7 and knight g7, maybe if required king d7, rook b8 and rook c8, and later black can put more pressure on queen side, and I feel black position is much better than white. So here he played queen e2, I played bishop g7, he played knight c3, I played queen d6, he played queen c4, I played knight f6, my idea was to do short castle as soon as possible because I am pawn up. So here he captured rook into e5. So viewers, just think in this position, take more 5 minutes, pause your video and feel who is better in this position, whether rook into a5 is good move or not, and how to react against this move. Well, I can tell you in this position I played knight g4. This move is a bit tough. Those who got, congratulations, and those who didn't find, don't worry. Sometimes it's happened, but you'll get another move soon. Rook into e4, rook e4, and I capture queen into h2, and black move, white move, rook king f1. Now the thing is, black main problem is this piece is hanging, this pawn is hanging, and in one move, it's very difficult to defend both the things. Now, of course, I played one move, queen h1 check, he played king e2. Now there is very important position, the problem is still here, and now you have to choose between c6 pawn and knight g4, how to react with black piece, what should you play, because my opponent was very confident in this position. I saw in his face, he believed that he is winning and he will be piece up immediately. So I also thought here for a couple of minutes, maybe around 5 minutes, so I think you should think in this position, and then you pause, first you pause the video and then you check how I react. Well, I believe many of you found a move. Those who didn't get, don't worry. This move was a bit tough. I played short castle. Why short castle in this position? I'll explain you. Because I believe in this position, my king should be safe and I should bring more pieces. My opponent king is in the center and I can put more pressure with, in future, rook d8, rook d6 and rook e6. It's called rook lift. And later I can bring my another rook to the d-file or I can play f5. Depends. So here it's not so easy to figure out why defense. Anyway, my opponent captured rook into g4, and when I played rook d8, my opponent thought if he played rook h4, again this his position will be clear better, because once I capture queen into g2, he can react with queen g4. And once the queen will be exchanged, white is winning, I believe. But the main thing was, I already prepared for all this thing. In the when I played knight g4 in the move number 15, I saw all this variation and I was confident that if my opponent will play rook h4, I'll play queen g1, and this is very natural move. The idea of the move is to prevent all opponent's threat. White can't move his bishop because this rook is hanging. He can't attack my queen with any other pieces. Even he can't exchange my queen now. It's impossible because my rook is dominating the d1 d-files fully, and I'm dominating with my queen the d1 square, and this c3 knight is preventing all the threats. And if he can't develop his pieces now, if I can bring my rook immediately, my position will be clear better. And it was really, I believe it's very difficult to defend with white, and it's very difficult to play this position with white piece. But to bring this position, you need lot of, you have to put lot of efforts, and you should put more focus in such position. You can easily bring and you can easily win also, I believe. So here opponent played rook b1. His idea was to immediately bring this c1 bishop to h6 or maybe e3 to trap my queen kind of way, so that I should capture g2 pawn and he can put his queen on g4 to exchange the pieces in the same way. Well, so here we can see all the threats. So I was also prepared for this rook b1. So I capture bishop into c3. At least first I stop his bishop moves. He capture queen into c3. And then I put queen d1 check and king e3. So here I bring my another rook to d6. He played b3. Now the main thing is, the idea was to play bishop b2 to put this threat on h8. So here now I have two major pieces on the board, and another one is rook f8, which is not playing, but I should bring my another piece on time. I have to. But here I played rook e6 check. Opponent played king f4. Again, he was planning to escape like g3 and h2. And his another plan is to play bishop b2 for this two mate. Now, viewers, think for 5 minutes in this position and figure out how to continue with black piece in this position. Well, I believe many of you found this move, and those who didn't, don't worry about that. You can learn many new ideas, and in future you will get such kind of moves during the game. All the best for that. So well, I played g5. So here you can see I am forcing my opponent to capture king into g5, because if he moves king g3, I can capture g into h4 and I'll be exchange up, and in future I'll win easily this game. So he captured king into g5, it was forced, and still he was thinking that he can escape in king f4 and king g3, king h2. Well, I played queen d5 check, king g4, rook g6. In such position, always remember, you should always think about tempo moves. Sometimes often waiting moves were required and it works, and most of the time tempo moves are required when your material down and your opponent king is roaming here, they are somewhere in the open middle game. So here he moved king f4. I played simple queen g5 check, because I'm getting this material back and I'll be exchange up. I'm more than happy. My opponent also realized that he's losing now, so he played king f3. I capture queen into h4, and he played g3. I played queen h1 check. He played king f4. I played rook f6 check. He played king g4. And in this position, I want my opponent king should come near to my king. And I feel very happy when I saw h5 move check, king g5, and a very natural nice move I played, which is king h8, and my idea is to play rook g8 mate. Now you can see, you can learn some three major pieces how it can works, and when you sacrifice some pieces in the early opening or maybe early middle game, you can say, and there how you can exploit your opponent king weaknesses. I can tell you, it's very truth, for this game I was not even prepared for this line before the game, and whole the game I played by myself during the game I thought and I played, and in such kind of tactical things, this thing I was not expected for me before the game, but when it came, I used this opportunity and I beat my opponent in such way. Then before the game also, again, if you will remember this about this game, you will is afraid. So viewers, I hope you like this game. In future we'll meet again, and I hope you like this video. You should see my all videos in the ChessBase site, in YouTube also, and in the game, during the game, you should follow all this technique which I taught in last few games and this game also. And later I'll show you some new ideas in little variation, and play well and do whatever you can, give your best efforts, don't afraid during the game, and you can do it. Play well, have a good day, bye bye.